Our stretch of unsettled weather does continue here over the next several days. Unfortunately, our weather pattern looking fairly stuck for a while. At the moment, skies are cloudy, but it is dry. We're checking in right now at about 59 degrees, so it's much cooler than average, another trend that's expected to continue. Now, we did get some healthy rainfall late yesterday, overnight, and early this morning. In fact, some of those rainfall amounts around and south of the Mass Pike ended up anywhere between about 5/10 of an inch to as much as an inch and a quarter. Out there in eastern Hamden County. But farther north of the Mass Pike, rainfall amounts were much lower, checking in with only a few tenths of an inch. And we have more rain on the way as we widen the view out and look at the radar loop here over the last couple of hours. Some pretty significant wind, some damaging wind, in fact, impacting the deep south right now. Mississippi getting hit hard. It's now extending into Alabama. They've got flash flood warnings. Severe thunderstorm warnings continue all the way into the mid-Atlantic. Luckily, that is not something we're going to have to deal with tonight. But showers are expected to return closer to midnight. So if you want to head out and do some stuff outdoors, go for a nice long walk, you can do it. You have a few hours before the wet weather returns. But once we get past 10, 11 p.m., rain starts to become more likely. And overnight, it could fall down heavy at times with even a rumble or two of thunder. For Wednesday, same story. We've got showers around in the morning, maybe a few breaks on occasion where it's just either raining very lightly or it's just overcast, but then more batches of rain will come through out through Wednesday evening. So it is an umbrella day for sure. As we go into the overnight hours, things will gradually be drying out. Might have a little bit of fog around for Thursday morning and then decreasing clouds with some decent sunshine finally for the afternoon. Of course, it is going to be fairly short-lived, so enjoy it while you've got it. Rainfall amounts through Wednesday night, in addition to what we picked up this morning, we're expecting anywhere between maybe a quarter of an inch to as much as 3/4 of an inch. If any thunderstorms develop overnight or tomorrow, that could push rainfall amounts even higher. Now, even though there's the threat for some thunder, we're not expecting anything severe. Just missing out on some real warmth across the mid-Atlantic today. Philadelphia 81, but New York City's dropped to 66, and we have got 50s across a good portion of New England. Tonight, temperatures back into the upper 40s, late rain with some thunder possible, again, most of it arriving after midnight. And for tomorrow, morning showers and then periods of rain throughout the afternoon. It'll be cloudy and cool with, again, high temperatures hitting low 60s. Some spots, again, not getting out of the 50s, though. Temperatures, I think, quite similar to today. If we can get some breaks in the rain, we might get just a little bit milder. Areas like Hartford possibly reaching some middle 60s, but I don't think we'll be that lucky here. For Thursday, good sunshine, but a gusty breeze. Wind out of the northwest could gust up to about 25 miles an hour. So it's going to add a bit of a coolness to the day, but it is going to be dry and bright and seasonably cool. Highs will be in the middle 60s. Friday, we're still hanging on to the low 60s, but the clouds return, and there's a chance for some showers Friday night, and a few showers can actually linger on and off throughout the day Saturday. Not calling this a washout yet, but it is trending more unsettled and cooler with highs in the mid-50s. Mother's Day, right now it's looking dry, but fairly cloudy, and there's the chance for a couple of showers Sunday night through Monday morning. Temperatures will start to rebound as we head into Tuesday as more sun returns, but it really looks like this pattern might continue through the mid part of the month. Chris and Jordan, back to you.